Let's now talk again about our workflow to generate executables. So we know already that we start with our source code, we run our compiler. Our compiler generates assembly code, which then results in an executable file, which is a program that you can run. But we haven't talked so much so far are the additional steps that are done by the compiler. So first of all, the compiler runs a so-called preprocessor, which changes all those macros that we know about and all those directives, starting with the hash sign. Then we run the compiler, which produces pretty much our assembly code in the machine architecture. The assembler generates an object file, and the object file gets then by the linker combined with libraries and multiple object files into our executable or our library if you want to create a library. So what we will learn is that the preprocessor, when it runs on a C file, it generates something that is called a compilation unit. So let's get started in this process and look at it first from a different angle. So basically, when you edit a program and want to execute it, first of all, what you need to do, you modify the source code in an editor of your choice, where we use the Atom a lot. Then the compiler runs this preprocess step, compiles the code that results from this preprocess step, which is our compilation unit. Then it links it together with all the objects that are needed. And then you try to load it into memory, the data into the memory using a so-called loader. And then this data gets basically in memory, gets executed, which is your program. So all those different steps, they typically interact with your storage to some extent. So when you save a file, it's a C file on disk. The preprocessor produces something that is a temporary file on disk. Compiler produces assembler code temporarily on disk. But this can mean any type of storage, SSDs or whatnot in this case.